Welcome to Factspark. The Harz National Park in the center of Germany has been a beloved nature retreat for Germans and international tourists for many centuries, but recently experienced one of the most dramatic forest diebacks, with hundreds of square kilometers of once lush green spruce woods dropping dead, leaving behind a seemingly deserted wasteland. Ever since humans stopped foraging the lands and instead settled down to conduct agriculture and eventually formed civilizations around 12,000 years ago, the percentage of forested area on planet Earth has been in a constant decline. Since the establishment of permanent settlements, wood has been a fundamental resource for construction, and deforestation was needed to prepare ever more area for agriculture. Today, wood is still a fundamental resource of human civilization, being used for construction, as an energy source, and for furniture, paper, and thousands of other uses. When discussing today's causes for a reduction in forested area, it is easy to just point at countries like Brazil or Nigeria, which cut down their natural rainforest in the megahectares per year. Taking an objective look at the situation, however, reveals that industrialized nations such as Germany also face their own issues, resulting in the loss of thousands of hectares of forest every year. One of these issues which I would like to address in this video is the case of the Harz National Park in central Germany, which has lost over 30% of its forested area between the years 2019 and 2021, and the forest dieback seems to only barely be slowing down. Chapter 1. The Harz in History. The reasons for today's dying of forest in the Harz National Park started many centuries in the past. The Harz, which is a middle mountain region in northern Germany, has been one of the oldest mining areas in Central Europe, with the extraction of copper kicking off the Bronze Age over 3,000 years ago. Over the millennia, large deposits of silver, iron, lead and zinc were discovered next to the still rich copper occurrences. The mining industry kept developing, and between the 16th and 19th century, around 50% of all ores taken from German grounds have been mined in the Upper Harz region. With this increase of the exploitation of natural resources, the first protection campaign started in the 18th century, applying to caves and the forest around the highest peak of the Harz, the Brocken. The popularization of the natural heritage by German poets of the time, such as Goethe, increased the awareness even more, but it couldn't prevent the further destruction of forest and the extinction of large mammals such as bears, wolves and lynxes in the area. The mining industry is founded on a huge demand for wood, which led to large-scale destruction of natural forests in the entire region. To counteract these developments and to ensure the future wood supply, spruce monocultures have been planted across the majority of the region, which resulted in the first large-scale bark beetle infestation in the year 1800. Nearly 40% of the forest died within the span of just a few years, and it took many decades to recover. The responsible for the reforestation of the area, however, have not learned from the disaster and continue to plant spruce monocultures across the entire region of the Harz until modern times. Chapter 2. The Harz today. While conservation efforts started in the 18th century already, parts of the Harz region only became an official national park in 1990. Today, the national park covers around 10% of the whole Harz region, and many of the problems from the bark beetle infestation of the year 1800 are resurging at terrifying intensities, especially when spruce forests are weakened from storms or extreme weather events such as heat waves or droughts. From these extreme weather events, the natural defense of the spruce tree in the form of tree resin is weakened or prevented entirely, which allows the bark beetle to feast off the tree and reproduce explosively. As a result of this, a death spiral for the spruce population kicks off. The monoculture additionally fueled the extremely fast spread, since there were no physical barriers in the form of other trees between the targets of the insect. Since the forests of the Harz region continued to be spruce monocultures all the way into the 21st century, it only takes another trigger for the death spiral, which already occurred in 1800, to repeat. With increasing climate volatility coming from man-made climate change, the next occurrence of a trigger event in the same scale was only a matter of time. Between the period of 2014 and 2018, Central Europe experienced 5 consecutive summers with long-lasting heat waves. The precipitation wasn't particularly low, but the increase in evaporation severely reduced the ground moisture levels across Germany, Czech Republic, Poland, and Slovakia, putting immense strain on the forests and agriculture industry. The increasing stresses year over year slowly fueled the spread of the bark beetle in the Harz region again, which in 2018 reached a devastating tipping point and eventually kicked off the second death spiral in 220 years, resulting in these apocalyptic landscapes. Comparing the tree cover from 2001 with the most recent data from 2021, a loss of 41% can be identified in the Harz region, with over 75% of the tree cover loss occurring in the years between 2019 and 2021. Hiking through the areas of the foot of the highest mountain of the region, the Brocken, reveals the levels of destruction, with only narrow strips of greenery separating the enormous fields of dead woodland. Chapter 3. The future of forest in the Harz. The destruction of spruce forests in the Harz have certainly not gone unnoticed. According to the website of the Harz National Park, a clear strategy forward can be found. The most important takeaway is the motto of "Let nature be nature," which now guides the decision-making in managing the national park and the rest of the Harz forest. The area is now split into two distinct zones, the Nature Development Zone and the Dynamic Nature Zone. As of 2022, 70% of the Harz forest is classified as a dynamic nature zone, meaning that here the nature is completely left to its own fate without any human intervention. The goal is the creation of a forest which is as similar as possible to how the primeval forest in the area would have looked like. With enormous areas of the forest having fallen to the bark beetle, the dead trees now form the bottom of the new food chain, which will slowly be processed by fungi and microorganisms, fertilizing the ground and allowing whichever tree will be the strongest to rise. It is hoped that a diverse set of conifer and deciduous trees, as well as grasses, mosses, and the old fauna will repopulate these areas. The other 30%, which is considered nature development zone, is still under human supervision. These zones mostly encompass areas with intact spruce populations, where the development of natural forest is accelerated. Some spruce trees are cut down and replaced with a diverse set of other native trees to prevent the advancement of the bark beetle. The plan is, however, that as soon as they are ready, these zones will also be passed on into the hands of Mother Nature. For now, visitors to the Harz National Park have to be patient if they want to experience the lush green canopies which once hung over the hiking trails. While the forest floor shows signs of recovery in many places, it will take decades for the forest to come back to its former beauty and strength. But this is the sacrifice which our generation has to take for the next one to enjoy the delicate nature of Central Europe. As a famous Greek proverb once said, "A society grows great when old men plant trees in whose shade they will never sit."